Hello friends and welcome back to the world of sound. My name is Nikolai. I am a Bulgarian voiceover artist and I did voiceover work for companies like BMW, Audi, DHL, Lidl, Toshiba and many others. In my work I often use many different microphones and preamps. Today I'll present to you something cool, a bit nostalgic and very interesting. The products that I will review for you definitely sound great. They have a tremendous amount of value for your music production arsenal. And most importantly, finally, we are able to land on some very nice products that were produced and developed here in Europe. I'm super happy to present to you the brand IGS Audio. IGS Audio is a pro audio equipment brand based in Poland that was founded in 1997. The company designs and specializes in designing, manufacturing high-quality analog gear, including compressors, equalizers, preamps, and other signal processing equipment. They also use some meticulous testing procedures just to ensure that each piece of gear meets their high standards. Today, the topic will be 500 series and IGS's own interpretation on that. Let's start with the basics. The 500 series audio gear is a modular audio processing system that was introduced in 1985 and since then has become a popular choice for audio engineers and musicians alike. The 500 series consists of individual modules that can be mixed and matched to create a customized signal chain. Each module is housed in a standardized 500 series rack and can be easily swapped out or added to as needed. One of the main reasons why people like the 500 series is its flexibility. The modular design allows users to create a signal chain tailored to their specific needs, and the ability to swap out modules means that the system can be easily adapted as those needs change. Another reason why the 500 series is so popular is its sound quality. But the main complaint that circulates in the whole universe about the 500 series is the noise. Many people complain that the lower quality and the cheaper brands have this problem almost constantly, but the truth to the matter is that API, the first developer of this system, also suffers from this phenomenon in some cases. This info can be found in many reviews and other sources. That's why companies like IGS Audio developed even further their own versions of 500 series to completely solve those problems. When I contacted IGS about their 500 series, my first question was about the noise. The manager of the company told me the following quote: "Our Panzer lunchbox is quiet as a stone." One good reason for that is that their power supply is located out of the lunchbox or with the chassis of the system. And yes, that is truth. Their Panzer lunchbox is super quiet. Like I told you, I'm a voiceover artist, not a musician, so I will read a few examples for you. To be honest, I prefer that instead of vocal or instrument, because hearing a human speech, you can hear more clearly elements like warmth, color, character, punch, etc. But just for fun, I will ask if a friend can join me and also perform a male vocal for our demo purposes. Today I'll show you three IGS products: NE573 preamp, 576 blue stripe compressor and the Panzer lunchbox. Let's start with my favorite one, an EVE style preamp, but transformed by the IGS's own audio prism to be built like a tank and at the same time to have the glorious vintage character. Switchable impedance and buffered instrument make it an ultimate workhorse for your studio. You can use this preamp on everything from microphones to guitars or even line level sources. The second studio item that I want to show you is the 576 blue stripe compressor. People call it punchy and impressive. I will combine the preamp and the compressor. Actually, let's do that now. So far, the sound that you hear comes from the following chain. My trusty Sennheiser 416 goes directly to my RME UCX2 sound card. Now let's switch to IGS Audio. From this moment, you're hearing the IGS preamp and the compressor. After a moment, I'll show you my voiceover in a vocal booth. It will be a tremendous difference because here the room is not well treated and also I'm quite far from the microphone right now. In short, about NE573 preamp, I simply love the modern touch with the amazing retro Neve flavor. Now just a few words about the compressor. The 576 Blue Stripe is a vintage type FET compressor that will remind you about Urey 1176 But again, with modern components and enhancements, the 576 Blue Stripes' major selling point is its ultra-fast attack time of 20 microseconds. The ratio buttons allow for different modes of operation, 2-to-1, 4-to-1, 8-to-1, 12-to-1 and 20-to-1 ratio, plus SLAM or all buttons in trick mode. Basically, with this compressor, you also get super versatility and great sound. Now it's time to go to the vocal booth and to read a few voiceover lines just for you. The unique gain staging employed in 1073 module uses two distinct transistor-based gain stages on the input stage, layered on top of each other. These amplifiers do the heavy lifting, bringing the level up to -15 dBU. The final transformer-coupled output amplifier then brings the signal level up to line level. This unique layout helped produce the high gain level required for music recording. In the 1960s and 70s, Class A amplification design was still the best way to amplify an audio signal, with one amplifier handling 360 degrees of the waveform. By having multiple Class A gain stages working together, the 1073 was more efficient than its predecessors. Additionally, this design allowed the 1073 preamp to handle low and high sensitivity microphone sources while maintaining a low noise floor. I hope you like my short voiceover demo. Now, let's include some male vocals in our examples. The main vocalist is my good friend Bojan Gegu from the band Hangar 42. The link for the band can be found in the description of the video down below. Enjoy!
I'm coming home, baby, now. I'm coming home now right away. I'm coming home, baby, now. I'm sorry now or ever run away. Every night and day I can always say I'm coming home. I'm coming home, baby, now.
You know I'm waiting for you.
I'm coming home now real soon. I've been gone.
You don't know why I'm going through.
I'm coming home.
There you have it, guys, my extensive test of the IGS Audio preamp, compressor and lunchbox. Overall, the 500 series audio gear is a popular choice for audio professionals who value flexibility and high quality sound. While it may not be the best choice for everyone due to its cost in some cases and lack of standardization between different brands modules, it actually has earned a solid reputation among those who swear by it. And our hero of the day, IGS Audio, easily find its own firm place in this crowded league of 500 series masters. And before I quit today's review, here is the second best thing about this company. After the great sound and quality, the whole IGS team is super helpful and always responsive. I don't want to bash some other companies here, but there is another famous Polish brand for audio gear. I will not mention any name, but when I tried to contact them more than a week, no email, no answer or any feedback from them whatsoever. And also their pricing is a lot higher than IGS. I hope that this can illustrate the picture for you. And if that matters to you, the design of IGS gear is also a lot nicer than the other Polish brand. The choice is yours. I am Nikolai from BulgarianSound.com, your honest gear advisor. I hope that you found today's episode interesting, helpful, or at least entertaining. Be well and keep a good mood and only positive emotions. Peace.